just hope that you guys stay together long enough for Tuesday.
Watch out! I got my crown on.
I'm really, really hot.
I'm calling Nerd Alert.
You heard him. Her, you heard her. I'm so sorry.
Oh my God.
Hey everybody, welcome back to Larry Tech Talk, the only podcast from Southfield hosted by people named Anthony and Allison. I'm Anthony.
I guess that makes me Allison. We want to give a big thanks to everyone who listened to and shared our previous episodes, and a big thanks to our sponsors, Cottage Inn Pizza on Lasher Road and 5th Avenue in Royal Oak. Before we get to today's discussion, we have some updates for all the Blue Devils out there.
So this week and next week are Rush Week. If you're interested in joining a Greek organization, visit the atrium. Greek members are hanging out there for you to talk to, hang out with, or maybe join. Or if you're just interested in free food, that's also available in the atrium. In case you forgot or just didn't know, Lil Dicky will be playing the homecoming concert on September 23rd. In unrelated news, The Magnificent Seven hits theaters on September 23rd as well.
That is definitely unrelated news, and no one needed to know that. Except for people like you, of course.
Except for people like me.
Anyways, men's soccer will be playing
on Friday, September 9th at noon. I have more updates.
Okay, go finish your updates.
So if you caught the previous episode, you might have noticed that we are posting to YouTube now. We may or may not be returning to SoundCloud, but we will keep posting to YouTube for everyone who finds that easier to use.
Now that Anthony's done with his updates, men's soccer will be playing on Friday, September 9th at noon, and women's soccer will be playing at 5, both out on the new turf field, so be sure to come out and show your support. Now it's time for my favorite topic! Game of Thrones! Who's excited?
I guess I am.
Me too.
Oh, we have our guest!
So joining us is one of the co-hosts of Speak of the Devil, Gabe O'Neil.
Woo!
What's up?
Gabe, how was your summer?
I had a marvelous summer. Thank you, Anthony. How was yours?
It was just fine. Maybe if you had listened to the last episode, you would know exactly how my summer went.
It was just common courtesy to ask, man. Uh-huh.
So, season 6 started just after we recorded episode 12 of season 1 last semester, so we thought we'd take time to discuss this most recent season. So, where do you want to start? A lot happened.
A lot happened. A lot.
Do you want to start somewhere? So, friggin' Jon Snow came back. Oh, wait. Spoilers for everybody who's not caught up.
Do not listen to the rest of this podcast if you aren't caught up.
Or do if you don't care.
Yeah, really.
Okay, so Jon Snow's back.
He's back.
He's
back.
Undead.
He's back.
Thank God.
I know.
Were you really, like, did you have any doubt that he would...
No, I knew he'd come back. I just thought he would come back later in the season, not
the second episode. Right away.
Yeah. I'm like, he's coming back, but not the second episode.
The only problem with that now is I feel like he's immune now.
What?
I feel like once you come back, you're not going to die again.
Right, neither is the mountain.
Yeah, the mountain.
That's true, yeah.
But.
No, I think Jon Snow could still die.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He didn't die at the Battle of the Bastards, and there were a couple moments where it really looked like he was going to die.
That was like the realest scene.
I was getting so mad. I'm watching him like...
I felt like I was suffocating at one point when he was underneath all those guys.
Yep. That was such a well-done scene.
It was.
Did you check out that video that I sent you at all?
There
was like a video that I found by Cinefix, and it was like 4 ingenious moments from the Battle of the Bastards, and one of them was Rickon's death. And it was like, things usually happen in threes, and they take all this time for the third arrow to strike and all the cuts and stuff, and you make it seem like, oh, this is the one that's going to hit him. And then when it doesn't hit him, you're like, okay, he's in the clear. And then that last one is just designed from a screenwriting standpoint to just, you know, hit you in the chest.
Catch you off guard so hard.
In the Battle of the Bastards, I had like some hope that Ramsay was not going to kill, what's the little Stark's name?
Rickon?
I honestly thought, I'm like, he's making it back. Like, Jon's coming to get him.
Well, Rickon doesn't matter.
What?
No, he was completely irrelevant.
He's done nothing.
But still.
At all.
I don't care.
I'm glad that he died, but I'm also glad that Jon... I love that final scene where Jon goes after Ramsay with the shield.
Impressive.
Aegis blocking the arrows. That was awesome.
Everyone was like, hey, man, we'll help you out. He's like, no, I have a shield. It's good.
He's the best. I love him so much.
He's good. Was there anything else with John that you really, really liked? Mm. Or was it just the Battle of the Bastards?
Wait a minute. The fact that he is Lyanna Stark's son?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that was finally confirmed.
Well, we all knew that along. The conspiracy theories and...
But there's a lot of conspiracy theories.
But that was a really good one. I just didn't like how long it took to, like, get to that point. You know, they had the flashbacks at the very beginning of the season, and then it was like, all right, like, what's going on? And then the very last episode of season six, you know.
I think I would have preferred, instead of constantly going back to that flashback with Ned Stark in the tower, mm-hmm. like, throughout the season, I think it would have been better for that all to have just been one
flashback
later in the season.
Right. Because then it was kind of harder to keep track of what exactly was going on, but still got the gist of it.
Right, yeah. Well, at one point I forgot. I was like, what about the flashbacks? And then finally, you know, four episodes later.
Finally they go back.
For
me, some of the season was kind of disappointing, because the first half of it was just people coming back, but not a whole lot else happening, it seemed, or was that just me?
Nothing really,
Because the last few episodes, like, a lot happened. Mm-hmm. You know, you had the Battle of the Bastards, you had the wildfire, you had...
What happened before the Battle of the Bastards?
Khaleesi just took over
with
her dragons.
That's true, she's finally on the move.
Yes!
And I think that's what you're, like, saying, like, the whole waiting concept in the middle of the season where there was a lot of, like, downtime. It was just all building up to Khaleesi and Jon, you know, just taking over.
Doing the thing.
Right, but I wish that a little bit more had happened.
Because
That season started, too, like, a week or two after I did The Walking Dead 5 with, where I praised Game of Thrones for being great and not wasting my time.
Like, Walking Dead, yeah.
And then they were like, oh... Let's just do this to make Anthony look like a fool.
Well,
George R. R. Martin specifically targeted me.
He doesn't like me.
I don't know. I thought the one episode, I don't think it was the Battle of the Bastards, the one where they were mostly at King's Landing and the whole Cersei, like, blew up.
With the wildfire?
Yes.
Yes.
That was insane.
That was awesome. I loved that she got the leg up, and now she's ruler of everything.
Yep. Well, I'm not happy about that, but...
Well, I think it's a nice stage setter.
Because that happened, there's not going to be another long waiting period for something to happen
in Westeros. Especially since these next two seasons are going to be shorter. It's going to be like 7 episodes six. Like, yeah.
Yeah, it's stupid.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
But hopefully that means that they really are going to get shit done.
Lady Olenna is with the Viper, and Daenerys is on her way to Westeros, and...
Right, they're all coming.
The Starks are on their way, and...
They're gonna... I think they're probably gonna, like... So they're gonna come to King's Landing.
Right.
And they're gonna take it. I have a feeling that maybe, I'm hoping that Jaime will... Because I feel like Bronn is going to side with Tyrion.
Right.
In the end. And I hope that what Jaime will do is decide to, if not Targaryens, side with Starks because of Brienne. And because of Cersei.
I don't think he'll ever betray Cersei.
I feel like Jaime's going to have to make that choice. To like.
Because we never saw his reaction after the wildfire, did we?
He does come back at like the very end of the season to see that she's queen, and he's... just kind of standing over in the shadows.
Oh, yeah, that's right, yeah.
And he doesn't look like he's happy about it.
No, I think that will end him and Cersei's whole...
Yeah.
It means no more incest.
Brother, sister, yeah, it's...
sex for them.
But I do hope... I feel like Jaime's going to have to make the choice of, like, okay, my sister needs to be stopped.
She's bad shit crazy.
She's killing everyone. And I feel like either Cersei or like the Mountain or... Jaime's going to make the right choice, but he's still going to die. That's what I feel like is going to happen.
Speaking of dying, we should talk about who we think is going to die next. Like,
boy.
Who are the main people to go? Like, who won't survive when the series ends?
Hmm. Cersei. Real quick,
Varys is totally going to live throughout the entire thing. Because not only is he, you know, all-knowing, but he can fly, we learned. Not actually, but did you realize how fast he moved from...
Yep.
Where Khaleesi is at? Dorne?
Oh, right. Well, he was moving all over the place. But...
Marine.
Although
Marine
one of the Dorne, yeah. one of the show's runners, like one of the showrunners was saying that the concept of time is a little wonky in the show, more for the sake of the story,
right?
Rather than being, you know, obviously has to take more time than that.
Yeah.
But yeah, I feel like he's gonna make it. I don't see Varys really getting into any kind of situation that'll get him killed.
Right.
I think Arya's gonna live.
Ooh, oh my gosh, what she did!
That was great.
So great.
I loved that. I was sort of on board with the Daredevil kind of training at the beginning, where she's all blind and shit, but...
Like, how would you feel just every day you're just waiting to get your ass beat by some other little girl that you all you can't see?
I did not like that little girl either. Oh, God.
No, she was spoiled. I didn't like her.
I don't know. Like, we gotta think, who's left? We've got Jon Snow, Daenerys, Tyrion, Sansa, Littlefinger's...
You want Littlefinger to die?
Yes.
Brienne's alive too.
I think she's. And gonna, I really I don't think want Brienne it.
To die, but I feel like she is. No, I feel like she's going to. Maybe she'll take the blow for Jaime, or maybe Jaime will take the blow for her. I feel like.
Ooh, I like that. I feel I like can something see that
regarding the two of them is going to come full circle, and then one of them is going to die for the other. I feel like Bronn's going to die too. Just because yeah, he's not quite really essential. Yeah.
But he's going to go down like a badass. Oh, he's going to
go.
Sure.
He better go down swinging. I think right. the Viper same with Brienne.
Won't make it.
The Viper's dead.
No, not the Viper. His wife. I'm sorry. I don't know.
Oh, yeah. I feel like she'll die.
And her three crazy daughters.
Did you see the disrespect that Marjorie's grandmother or whatever their last name is? That she showed those three girls every time they talked, she was like, "Yeah, no, shut the hell up."
I don't like her. I hope you don't like I do Lady hope Olenna. She, I don't know.
That's her name, Olenna.
I kind of like
her spunk, but in real life, I really wouldn't get along with her.
Yeah, probably.
Although I probably wouldn't get along with a lot of people in that show.
I definitely think she'll die.
Probably,
if not by murder, natural causes. She's old.
But there's one that's coming up that everybody's been talking about, and that's Clegane Bowl.
Oh.
Mountain versus the Hound, now that he's back.
Now we got to go back to everyone who's died and has come back that we thought. Is he going to fall under that category?
See, I'm hoping that he will defeat the Mountain.
Can he, though? Like, can the Mountain actually die?
I mean...
Again? Again? Isn't he, like... I don't know. Maybe they just.
I don't know.
Back to life. I don't
know. I mean, I'm sure. You know, if the Hound comes at him and succeeds,
cuts his heads off.
Because
cuts
his head did off. Did the guy who brought him back to life, the Mountain? Did the guy who brought the Mountain back to life die yet?
I forget. He's still alive.
So he's still alive, but he's probably gonna die.
Oh yeah.
He's gonna get killed. So there's gonna be no one to reanimate the Mountain again. So if the Hound gets him, that'll be it.
Right.
And then I'm hoping if he wins in that bracket, he'll then either have a rematch with Brienne.
The Hound?
Yeah.
It's like been double elimination for a couple people, but
but I also hope that doesn't happen because I love Brienne and the Hound.
Well,
and
Arya I don't want either of them to and die. The Hound are probably gonna meet back up.
Yeah, but do you think they're gonna get along, or is Arya gonna finally scratch him off the list?
Does she already think she did cross him off the list?
Yeah, she already. Yeah.
I'm not because technically she didn't end his life.
Right.
No, I feel like Arya understands that she didn't actually kill him, but I feel like she also didn't want to at that point, but didn't want to keep traveling with him either.
Yeah.
You know.
I think she kind of. But by not killing him, she was more satisfied because she thought he was just going to bleed out or, you know.
Right.
Sure. Yeah. And she probably felt like, you know, like big man because she didn't take the life.
Right.
You know, but I just hope that she, I can't wait for her to get back together with John and finally. Sansa. Yeah. I hope they do.
What did you guys think about that little 12-year-old princess?
Oh, that helped name. John?
She's yeah. going to die.
Oh, she's for sure going to die.
She's going to die by the age of 15.
That's yeah, going to be gruesome, easily. Too. Definitely. But she's cool. I liked her.
She definitely served a good role.
I hope she keeps doing that, though. Like, she's another one that I hope goes down swinging.
Well, she probably will.
You know?
Or in some battle.
I don't know.
They're
going to have. Jorah. Remember Jorah? The old guy that's in love with Daenerys?
Oh my gosh. No, he's for sure going to die because he's got that
Yeah, he's for sure going to die, but do you think he's going to die from the grayscale or die fighting for Daenerys?
Where is he right now?
He's off searching for a cure, I think.
Yeah, because she ordered somewhere. Him to do so.
I don't know, maybe he could
Because
get
she realized
cured
she can't get rid of him.
What about the other guy that she told to stay back in Meereen?
Oh, her boyfriend?
Yeah.
He'll probably die.
Yeah.
He'll probably be killed in, like some kind of citizen uprising.
I think he might go AWOL.
Yeah.
Just maybe. Because he's so mad right now because, you know, Nerys yeah. is like, hey, I might no, have to go marry to say... some other guy. You're not worthy of me. Sorry.
Jeez.
I liked him, though. I thought he was cool. He's another one that's probably going to die, though. It's like, it's hard
Literally
to...
everyone can die, though. What if they did... That's just how the series ends. Everyone dead. End of Game of Thrones.
What if Tyrion dies?
He pro...
Mm. We got to start taking out some of the big characters,
It's good.
No.
Who's like, the... We've got Cersei. She's dying.
Oh, Cersei's going to die.
Yeah.
But
not
probably...
Not to the very end.
Probably either
end.
By the end of next season. Because I feel next season is going to be all about taking King's Landing.
Yeah.
And by the time they take King's Landing, the White Walkers will really be a threat, so they're all going to have to team up and go against the White Walkers.
The three biggest characters to go by, probably Cersei.
Jaime's.
You think Jaime?
I think Jaime's time is almost up.
Maybe Sansa. Or
maybe Littlefinger.
Okay, well, he's not that, like, major, but I hope
he
dies.
Well, I know.
I think Jon Snow will kill Littlefinger.
Yeah.
I hope that he does. Or Brienne. I hope somebody on Team Stark kills... Or Team Snow. I hope somebody on Team Snow kills Littlefinger.
Oh, I hope so, too.
Or maybe Littlefinger will kill Sansa for whatever reason.
I don't know. I just... Well, you know Cersei's gonna die because the prophecy or what have you that witch gave her.
Well, yeah, the witch said that she would be, like, all alone. I think, mm-hmm. which came true with her last son just stepping out the window.
And Jamie's going to be the last one to leave her, and then she'll die.
Right,
so,
yeah.
You know, foreshadowing when that happens, she's going to die soon after.
Yeah, I think, like you said, it probably won't be till the end, though.
Okay.
I don't know. We don't see her getting killed off.
That's the best part about the show, though. You never
know
what's going on.
That's true.
Yeah, and what sucks is when you do get attached to somebody.
Right.
I am
like,
not attached
to
her.
I got really attached to the Hound, and then he got... up. Oh, sorry. But then, like, I liked Robb Stark.
Oh, I
liked
Robb
Ned.
Stark. Yep. When he died.
All the Starks. So, God, such nice guys.
Yep. The Starks are great. Oh, and then they all died.
We forgot about, Reek.
Theon Greyjoy?
Yeah.
Oh, my God, yeah.
Because they're in alliance with Daenerys.
They're in alliance with Daenerys.
Yeah,
right now.
I feel like Theon's.
His sister's gonna die.
Oh, probably. Or. Theon will probably die, too. If he hasn't come full circle yet...
Kill himself.
He probably is going to eventually. Mm. You know? And by that point, it's just like, why are you... We don't need you anymore.
Right.
Yeah, he's becoming more and more irrelevant.
Right.
Yeah, he's just kind of there.
Yeah.
All right, we're going to take a real quick break just to hear a word from our sponsors. Stick around for another 60 seconds.
Lawrence Tech students know that not all pizza is the same, and Cottage Inn Gourmet Pizza is the LTU favorite. Cottage Inn Pizza on Lasser Road is close to campus and ready to bring hot pizza, wings, breadsticks, subs, salads, calzones, and cold beverages right to your dorm with the fast delivery service. Save your Blue Devil dollars and carry out the Cottage Inn LTU special, a large two-topping pizza and small breadsticks for only $12.99. Cottage Inn is a proud sponsor and the official pizza of Blue Devil Broadcasting.
Fifth Avenue in Royal Oak is the premier entertainment destination with great food and drink specials in front of the most TVs in the metro area. Our private second floor is great for parties, concerts, and the best club experience on Friday and Saturday nights. Don't settle for the ordinary. Make it a Fifth Avenue night.
All right, and we are back.
Hey!
So, we were talking a little bit about, like, who we think was going to die, who we think should die. But now another thing that's interesting, beside, like, who do you think's going to ride with Daenerys on the dragons?
Jon Snow.
Jon Snow, and I think Tyrion.
Yes.
Because they did actually, because everybody's been, like, hinting at it and talking about it, but in this season, we actually saw that scene where he goes into the caverns, and he, like, takes the collars off of the dragons.
Yeah.
And they don't eat him.
That was terrifying.
I was waiting for him to get cooked.
I was like, he's such a little snack for them. That might be why they didn't. Like, we're so hungry. We've been down here forever. You're not going to work for us. We got to go find something else.
Oh, you know who's probably going to die is Grey Worm.
Oh, that'd be so sad. And his
and his friend, the translator. They're probably gonna die.
Probably.
What's her name? Melisandre?
Yes.
No,
that's
the red woman.
That's the red woman.
She better die, but God. She kind of just left.
Yeah, she's just gone.
Well, Jon Snow told her to leave.
Mm-hmm.
She's gonna come back with something, you know, because she said I'll die when God of Fire, God of Light, whatever she worships, said, you know, when he's done with me, then I'll die.
Right. Well, didn't you see when Daenerys was talking to, like, it looked like another red woman with her necklace?
Oh, yeah.
Is that, like, red woman number two?
Maybe it's, like, a cult. Maybe. Like, seriously.
She can't be the only one in it, yeah.
Right.
No, like, that could very well be. I haven't seen The Hobbit movies, but I hear that there's, like, a brown wizard, too. Mm-hmm. And my friend said there's, like, blue wizards, so, like, it would make sense that, you know...
You're talking about The Hobbit, that was three movies, that should have been one.
Right, but it's high fantasy like Game of Thrones is, so, right. Like, it would make sense that there would be multiple, like, people who do that kind of stuff in a group together.
Yeah, I'm sure. Well, what I was thinking is, technically, only one person can have the Iron Throne, right?
Right.
I mean, from what we know, so... Who gets the Iron Throne then?
Well,
Daenerys, Jon Snow. I guess
Jon and Daenerys are both eligible for the throne. maybe they'll marry.
Oh my!
How about that?
Gosh, yes.
How Snogarian?
Snogarian.
That'd be neat.
But technically, who who is the rightful heir? So if you think Baratheon.
Maybe Daenerys would be more...
None of Cersei's daughter or sons should have been.
Wait.
Technically.
Daenerys' father is the one that that raped Ned Stark's sister, right?
Yeah.
So that would...
They're brother and sister.
Like, half-brother and sister. But because Jon's the man, would that make him more eligible? Or because Daenerys wasn't born out of wedlock...
I don't know. They're probably going to have to fight for it. Fire and ice.
Ooh.
Because technically, wouldn't he be a bastard either way? You know, obviously.
Yeah, technically, he still is a bastard.
He's still a bastard.
But he's...
Do you think... Like, I know Daenerys is very much like, I'm in charge. Mm-hmm. I'm going to rule.
Mm-hmm.
But do you think once she comes across Jon and they interact a bit, do you think maybe she'll be a little bit more like, okay, we can both rule together?
I think that
he'll
step down and let her take Westeros and, like, you know, he'll go back to Winterfell, yeah.
Oh, yeah, that.
But then you got Sansa getting all this chatter from Littlefinger, like, she should be the one, the Lady of Winterfell, and keep Jon out of it.
I don't think Sansa's that power hungry, though. I think Sansa just kind of wants everything to be over.
Yeah.
Because
she's gone through a lot.
She's going through a lot of crap. You know what's really interesting to me is the amount of Valyrian blades that we have now. Because Jon has his.
Mm-hmm.
Brienne has Oathkeeper, which Jaime gave her.
Yep.
And those...
Just the only thing that
Brienne's was made from Ned's that was melted down.
Yep.
Who was the other one? The other one was given to Joffrey, right?
I don't know. Was there only three?
Well, no, okay, so, like, Ned Stark's big sword.
Yeah.
That was Valyrian steel.
Yes.
And after he died, whoever, like, Papa Lannister was, I forgot his first name. Papa Lannister was like...
Tywin.
Yeah.
He said, melt down the sword, make it into two new swords.
Yeah.
One of those swords went to Jaime.
Yeah.
Who he then gave to Brienne.
Yeah.
And she's like, this is going to be Oathkeeper, and right. This episode's going to be Oathkeeper. And then I think the other one went to Joffrey. But I don't remember who got it after Joffrey died.
Tommen? What's his name?
But he's dead too.
And I don't know. Maybe Cersei has it.
But Samwell also got... Or Samwise?
He has like a shard.
Samwise is...
Is that Lord of the Rings?
Yeah. Lord of the Rings.
I think he's just Sam.
Fat Sam took his father's Valyrian steel sword.
He did.
When they visited the parents.
But he's busy being a maester.
He's learning to be a meister, but you know
maester.
That maester.
Learning to be the snowmeister.
Maester.
Well, if he ends up serving Jon Snow again, then he could be the snowmeister.
I think that's how it's going to end up.
But I think Jon Snow, you know, if he were to reach out to him, or he were to hear that Jon needs more help, like, he would go help him in a heartbeat. So that's two more Valyrian swords. And we learned that Valyrian steel can kill White Walkers no problem.
Yep. So Arya, her little needle isn't a Valyrian steel, is it?
What's it? I don't think so.
Needle? I don't think so.
Who gave that to her, Jon?
Her dad.
It was either John or Ron. No, it was John.
No, it was definitely John.
John did give it to her.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure it was not Valyrian.
But they never said it was Valyrian.
Okay.
Because it's all rare at that point.
Yeah.
I think you had to get over in Easteros, didn't you?
I don't know.
I'm just trying to think, because they only have so many Valyrian weapons.
Yeah.
And I think Sam has, like, the glass, the dragon glass? So they have a very finite amount of weapons that can kill the White Walkers.
Mm-hmm.
So either those people need to stay alive, or
someone
else needs to get those weapons and come together.
Right. They're not going to figure that out, though, right away.
Mm-mm.
And by that time...
I mean, John and Sam know. They know how those work, because they've both killed people.
Right.
Because you don't have to have Valyrian steel to kill all the army of the dead.
Right. You don't need it, but it does. It's like the most effective.
Right.
Well, Bran's coming back over the wall.
Oh yeah, Bran.
So, he's got the key.
Yeah.
He's got all the info.
Yeah, I hope he really does like some damage. Hopefully. I want him to warp into someone and or some big thing.
Well, weren't you say we were like, yeah, Bran's probably gonna die, but I'm like, no, probably not, because he can just.
He could take over one of the dragons, probably.
Like, be a dragon?
Like, morph into a dragon.
Being killed?
The raven told him that he would fly at one point in the show, didn't he?
Yeah.
So, maybe it means he's going to take over one of the dragons.
Maybe. I like that.
He's taken over animals before. He's taken over his own wolf.
Yeah.
Right.
For the majority of the time that, they were together.
I like that idea.
Real quick. Hordor dying. Tears.
God.
So many tears.
That was one of the moments that I got teary eyed.
Oh, it was so sad.
And I was like,
I actually
started hating Bran at that point.
Really?
Only because like through the time travel and shit, he's the reason Hodor is mentally retarded.
Yeah, there's no way he could have ever known.
No, he wouldn't have known, but it's
That's
still
so
like,
sad.
Right.
You know, still, now you know the reason. It's not like he got kicked in the head when he was young.
Yeah.
Right.
Some other kid traveled
he
through time.
He just fell down in the middle of
the
village.
Yeah.
Started screaming,
I thought,
hold the door.
Like when that whole thing happened, was Bran responsible for everything, maybe? Or he could change things,
maybe.
Go back and change
stuff?
It
might all be Bran's fault.
Blame Bran.
Plot twist.
because when he went back in time and he was, he could see Ned and stuff, and Ned heard him, he could have, done something, maybe changed time, or, I don't know. Maybe not. Maybe I'm just looking into it too much, but... interesting.
I don't know. I think it might be interesting. I don't know if they'll do it this way, but I feel like he's eventually also going to meet back up with Team Snow. And
Bran? Oh, yeah.
Yeah, and I feel like at that point, maybe that by that point they'll have met Dany and her dragons, and and he'll be like, you know, he'll be like, John, you have Targaryen blood. You can control the dragons. And John will be like,
okay. Get on a dragon.
All right.
Oh, shit.
And like, get on one of the dragons, and then they can be off.
And then he just throws Tyrion
and
on one.
And then, Tyrion can spend a while, like, struggling to get up or ask for a ladder or something.
Oh, man.
That'd be great.
I was just going to say something. I totally blanked. I'm totally spacing right now. It was earlier in the season. What happened earlier in the season? Jon Snow came back.
Oh my god.
Oh, I was just going to say something about coming back. Lady Stoneheart was supposed to come back.
Right. I heard that she was going to be coming back.
She never did.
That's Lady Stark, mm-hmm. like reanimated.
Mhm.
Does she have magic powers? Do you know?
No, I just know that she's supposed to come back and get revenge on everyone basically who have done the Starks wrong. She's supposed to come back and kill a lot of people.
That would be nice. Which, good for Arya.
Yeah.
For killing Filch.
Yeah. Well, that's every time he was in a scene, I was like, where's his cat?
Such an asshole. But yeah, they're all good. They're good actors. Oh, but every time I see someone like the Filch guy or the High Sparrow.
Yeah.
Every time I saw the High Sparrow, I just thought of Elizabeth. Yeah. That's what I thought of, and I hated it, because
so did I.
He's really good as, like, the High Sparrow, but kept thinking of him as the governor.
Yeah, because once you get pegged with, like, a series like the Harry Potters or the trilogy of... No, there's more than three.
There's four Pirates movies.
I don't know.
There's another Pirates coming out.
Number 5 is coming out, like, next year.
I need to stop.
Yeah, I need to stop.
I enjoyed even number 4.
I don't know if I saw number 4.
No. One didn't have Orlando Bloom in it, I didn't like.
Number 4.
Yeah, that's
But number 5 is going to have him. He's coming back.
Oh, that's
good.
Well.
But.
Yeah, what a stud.
But yeah, like, so Filch is dead. The High Sparrow is dead. You know, the assholes are dying. That's nice.
I'm pumped the sparrows are gone.
Oh, they're.
I hated them so much throughout the thing. Like, they were fine villains, but I just really wanted them to... I wanted them gone.
Yeah.
They took an element of all the all the blackmailing mm-hmm. and the lies. They kind of took that element out of King's Landing, I think.
Yeah.
Because they made everyone either...
Naked shame walk or...
Yeah, naked shame walk them. Or keep them in captivity until they confess.
Yeah. I liked that they're gone. I feel like that does make room for... whatever other shenanigans are going to go on in King's Landing.
Literally
like Jaime and Cersei are going to have their drama.
So many shenanigans.
You know.
Mountain and Hound. Everyone's coming.
I hope the Mountain and Hound fight. That's one of the big things I'm looking forward to is Clegane Bowl.
Clegane Bowl.
When does season 7 come out?
Probably next spring.
I heard it was a summer. I heard they pushed it back till June. Like June 26th.
Well, it better be good then.
like of this summer. June 26th.
No.
2017. I swear I read that somewhere.
I don't know.
Hang on.
I don't know. But while you're doing that, I just remembered Sir Davos. Is that his name?
Yeah.
The bearded guy on Team Snow.
Right.
I like him.
I do too.
I like him a lot, and I feel like he's going to die.
Oh, so gonna die.
He's gonna get... He's gonna... I like to hope that everybody's gonna die trying to, like, protect somebody else, because a lot of the people that are left are like more noble people, or they're becoming more noble, but I feel like he's gonna be a guy who's just straight up murdered. He's not gonna really be trying
assassinated
anything. Maybe like Littlefinger will get him out of the way while John's off doing something, but
because someone's gonna try and get to John, you know, tear down his spirits by taking out, because he's kind of like his left hand man now, right?
Yeah he's great. I love him. I liked him from the very beginning, and I, even when he was with Stannis, and I really hated Stannis.
Yeah.
I thought Stannis was too full of himself. But I loved his relationship with the daughter. I liked his relationship with Jon, and I just feel like he's going to get it.
I agree that he's either going to die by assassination or in battle, because he's, you know, he's not the best fighter.
No.
He's pretty old, you know.
He's old, but he's got spirit.
Yeah, no, I could see him spunky. Valiantly dying in battle as well, but mm-hmm. I agree, I do think it would be kind of a shitty death for him.
Yeah. Do we know, are there any more Boltons? Anyone else God, loyal to the not. Boltons who would want to come back to Winterfell?
All right, so let's hope not. They had a
pretty clean sweep of all the Boltons.
So it says HBO has made a habit of debuting new GOT episodes in the spring, ordinarily in early April, but this year it'll launch a little later in the summer months.
Well, I hope it's good. So
that's what I'm reading. Yeah, it's got a lot of spoilers on here. It even says filming won't even wrap up till February 2017, but to keep us going, here's a first look teaser.
Boy, oh boy.
For season 7. So it's probably... I saw a poster saying June 25th, but that's really late. Maybe it was like June 6th or something like that. But it was in June, so... I mean,
okay. It says so we have to wait a little longer.
Yeah, it says midsummer. Well, it usually starts in April.
Yeah.
April, May, June, so almost like 3 months. That's a lot longer, if you tell me. But I really want to watch this.
It better be worth it.
Teaser.
We can watch it after the show.
Yeah. Well, yeah.
Or we can let all the fans listening
listen to the...
They can just imagine the pictures happening.
Some vague lines of dialogue and
go
some...
to Digital Spy if you want to watch what we're watching. That's where I'm reading this from, so...
Oh, okay.
It's the website. But...
Are there any... Oh, Arya still has her direwolf alive. And Jon has Ghost, right?
Yeah.
Jon has Ghost. I don't know about Arya.
Arya's is still alive, I think, because after it bit Joffrey, like, in season 1, she just made it run away. And then that's why Ned had to kill Sansa's wolf right. instead. I heard that, like, in the books, Arya's wolf, like, is the leader of a pack now. And, like, comes back.
Which
would be great. More wolves. Crowd
wolves just come to save everyone. That's how it ends.
Arya comes riding in on her wolf with her tiny little sword.
Yeah, what's her sword's called?
Needle.
God.
I really want to know what happened to Tomlin's cat.
Oh, right. Tomlin had a cat.
I don't know. I just like the fact that he had an orange cat. It was so cute.
For a while, there were all these, like, everybody wanted that cat to be the next one to sit on the throne. And there were all...
Or get petrified.
There was, like, all of these, like, campaign posters and stuff made up of the cat sitting on the Iron Throne.
That would be hilarious.
That'd be great.
Tommen. I'm sorry, I've been saying his name wrong.
Whatever, wow, he's dead. I suck. Nobody cared about him anyway.
Deceased.
He sucked as a king.
I watched.
What? I liked him way better than Joffrey.
Well, he's more likable, but he sucked as a king.
Yeah.
I mean, he just let everybody push him around.
Oh, yeah.
That's true.
He let his mom push him around. Even, at least Joffrey was kind of like, no.
Yeah.
I'm the king.
Right.
I'm a shitty king, but I'm the king, yeah. Mom.
Well, Joffrey sucked. And he's dead, too. So.
And he's dead.
I don't know.
That might have been the most... exciting death in the show.
Joffrey's?
Yeah, him dying, I think, made more people happy than anyone else.
Oh, yeah, I was happy
dying.
About that.
I don't know, Ramsay's death.
Oh.
Ramsay was pretty satisfying, too. There was, for a while when Joffrey
was
still alive.
Didn't you say you liked Ramsay's?
No, I empathized with Ramsay.
How?
Because he just wanted the approval and respect from his bastard father.
Mm-hmm, yeah.
But his father was like, no, you're my son because I didn't wear a condom. I hate you.
His dad
was a prick. I was glad when he shanked him.
You know, even though he got, like...
Before he shanked him, he made him, like, a certified Bolton.
Yeah.
Well, yeah. And he's like, well, now I don't need my dad. F*** him.
Right. Yeah. I didn't see that one coming.
I was glad when that happened, though.
I was, too.
I was waiting for his dad to shank him.
Oh, yeah. I thought it was going to be the other way around.
Well, and
I
was, you know,
and I was waiting for, like, the wildling chick to... shank Ramsay too when they're like getting it on.
I knew that was it.
Yeah,
she
like,
had no chance
dying.
She was in something else too, she wasn't she in Harry Potter? No, she
was Tonks.
Yes,
in Harry Potter. Yeah.
She was.
Yeah.
Yep.
She had like purple hair.
Yep. Yeah,
yep. She
died in
that
too.
Could turn her face into different animals.
Oh yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, she had that little bit of power.
She had no power in Game of Thrones.
No, she was,
she was even just though he got mauled by the dogs, I really wish, like, they would have just, I don't know, had a better death for him.
For Ramsay?
Yeah.
Than getting his face eaten?
Yeah, like, something way worse.
But, like, he was, like, feeding other people to his dogs, so it's kind of fitting.
I know, but, like, I don't know, kind of, like, you know, cutting off, like, fingers at a time and, like
torching him like he did to Theon?
Yeah.
Well, Sansa's not quite that demented yet. But she was smiling.
I guess I am.
When they ate his face.
She kind of, like, turned away and didn't want to watch, and then she was like, yeah, I do.
Yeah, I want
to
see
she's,
your face.
I think she's starting to become malicious.
Good.
Yeah, I think that's, you know, that turn back was the start of that. And that's why I think that she could potentially get power hungry and
maybe
have a scuffle with old Johnny boy.
If she does get power hungry, though, I hope she realizes that Littlefinger needs to go. And if she does go down the power hungry path, that she'll just, you know.
Yeah, I don't think much will come out of it. Between her and John, if it does ever get to that level.
Well,
but
she was, like, lying. Well, not lying, but just not telling him everything. And I didn't understand why she just
wouldn't. I think she knew that he, you know, he'd be like, oh, we don't need them. No.
Yeah, I guess. I don't know. I'm like, why not trust him?
And maybe she also just wanted to like, surprise him and be like,
no, that's true.
Look how useful I am.
Look at me go. Woo!
Look at me, guys.
All right. Unfortunately, that's all the time we have for this episode.
Final thoughts. What was, like, your favorite moment from the season?
Oh. I don't know. That's a hard question.
I'll give mine.
Okay.
When the Hound, like, is officially back, when, like, everybody's dead, and he grabs the axe, and he finds the guys, and he kills the bandits,
that was awesome.
Like, I'm the Hound, and I'm here to do Hound things.
He goes, wait, when he was, like, fighting over, can I just, you know, kill him, not hang him, or do something? And they're like, no. And he goes, all right, one. I'm like, okay.
I love that. I love that so much. That and the one shot with the flying bell.
Yeah.
That they spent so much time and money on to make the CG bell ding off the building and hit a dude on the street. Those are my two favorite
moments.
That
was, they went way out of their way to make that known, that guy got demolished.
Oh, no.
That's why there wasn't much dragon stuff. All the money was going into the bell.
Right.
I think Jon Snow coming back to life, number one. And then number two was when Arya killed Filch.
Yeah, that's a good moment.
Fed him.
That would be my
three. Daughters.
I really liked when Arya killed the girl that was beating her up every day.
Yeah.
And brought her head to
and was
the
like,
man of no faces.
Yeah, and was like dying in the process, and then turns the light. Like, wait, didn't they fight in the dark too?
Yeah, she like cut the candle and the light went out.
And
because
still
she's got her daredevil
as
powers,
she's like
she
dying, just being
that was great.
A million times.
And she's just like telling the man with no face guy, he's like, okay, well, you can be back. And she's like, no. Yeah. I'm gonna go do other things. That was good. Good on you, Arya.
All right. Well, before we go, Gabe, do you have anything you want to say regarding Speak of the Devil?
Just tune in. I think we're gonna start coming out with episodes after this week.
Awesome.
And we're gonna have a lot more for everyone to check out. So tune in. Give us the likes, the shares on social media. Let's spread the word around campus for Blue Devil Broadcasting as a whole.
Yep.
And yeah, very excited.
Well, you heard that, everyone.
Yeah.
Get to it.
All right. Well, Gabe, thanks for coming on and talking Game of Thrones with us.
Love talking about God.
Gabe's the best. Gabe's the best.
All right. Before we go, we also want to thank our sponsors, Cottage and Pizza on Lasser Road and Fifth Avenue in Royal Oak. And, of course, we want to give a big thank you to everybody who listens to the show, shares it, and supports it.
Woo, thanks.
And be sure to follow us on Twitter at Larry Tech Talk if you haven't already. DM us or email us at LarryTechTalk@gmail.com if you have suggestions for us or want to come on the show and chat with us about something.
Yeah,
we'd love to have you.
Yeah, seriously, guys.
It's fun to chat.
It is.
Yeah. And our pizza. There's free pizza here
right now.
Who doesn't love free pizza, right? When you're broke. You have no money.
And the fog tastes like poop.
Poop. Yep. All right, well, stick around next week when we have more shenanigans we're going to talk about, guys.
We'll see you soon. Glitch, Peter Dinklage.